aid organizations supporting the refugees have been overwhelmed. The situation appears to be getting worse by the hour. Zein Basravi is in the border town of Adre, and a warning his report contains distressing images.
They've survived the violence in Sudan. In Chad, another struggle begins. Aid organizations say they were not prepared for the humanitarian crisis to become this big, this quickly. People arrive with gunshot wounds. One woman gave birth in this open field. They tell us men, boys, even young girls were taken prisoner along the way. But for some, the journey from West Darfur was too much.
The war has scattered people. The baby was sick and she died on the way here.
The baby's mother left her here to search for her other children. Her family in Chad is seeing her for the first time. They don't even know if she had a name. Those who make it try to find friends and relatives. There are reunions, but precious few.
The UNHCR is here. They are doing assessments, and someone told us that they have never seen it this bad, that they are incredibly underfunded. They do not have enough money to help people here with anything, and that the international community simply doesn't care enough about this crisis, that it is just pure chaos.
Some arrive only to bury the children they fled here to save. In the smallest graves, two girls and a little boy, none older than three. Their fathers did not make it across.
They died from weakness because they had no food, and their mothers didn't have the milk to feed them. They're dead because of hunger caused by the war, and not just them. Probably the numbers will go up in the next few days.
They tell us their government, their country, and the world have abandoned them. Their situation, they say, is hopeless. Zein Basravi, Al Jazeera, Adre, on the Chad-Sudan border.